She's starred in all the biggest musical productions in Australia, from West Side Story to Showboat and, of course, The Phantom of the Opera.
Yes.
Marina Prior is without a doubt our first lady of the stage, and she joined the one and only Craigie Bennett for this look back at her extraordinary career.
They are more than just songs and much more than a melody. The music of musical theatre tells a powerful and often emotional tale that can move the audience to laugh or cry. And there is nobody that takes us on a musical journey quite like Marina Prior. For Marina, music has been her life. She taught herself to play the guitar and would perform some rather risque songs for her parents and their friends.
My hit at the age of 9 was The House of the Rising Sun by The Animals, which is, of course, about like a brothel in New Orleans, but I had no idea. I used to just sort of sing it in this beautiful soprano for all my parents' friends.
And from there, you went on to busk in the Bourke Street Mall.
I did. I went into the Bourke Street Mall and just started singing, and it drew a crowd, and I thought, gee, this is nice, and yeah.
But not just any kind of busking. A little birdie told me it was the likes of Wuthering Heights.
It was. I wanted to be Kate Bush. Like, I thought I was Kate Bush, and it taught me immediately what works, because when I wasn't very good or did a wrong song, took a wrong turn, the audience just walked away and didn't throw money. And when I got it right, they stayed and they threw money in my guitar case. So I kind of started to figure out in a very raw way what holds an audience.
Marina would soon swap busking for Broadway musicals, and when she was 19, auditioned for a role in the hugely successful Pirates of Penzance.
I think I'm very, very lucky, because that first show was such a hit, and it had the likes of June Bronhill, who became a great mentor to me, John English, Simon Gallagher, just terrific people, David Atkins. And I learnt so much, and it was such a joyous introduction to showbiz. I couldn't have been luckier.
You must have been saddened with the passing of John English.
Oh, I was devastated. We were all devastated, because he was one of show business's good guys, you know, and what I liked about him, and I think what I like about my favourite people that I get to work with, is that he treated everybody the same. He would meet the Prime Minister and treat him the same as he treated the cleaner backstage. And that's what I loved about him. And that larrikin sort of element that he had, he never thought he was sort of above anybody else. And such a talent, so funny.
The Gilbert and Sullivan classic propelled Marina into the musical theatre stratosphere, performing in Cats, West Side Story and Les Mis. And at the age of 21, she was cast alongside the legendary Richard Harris in a special Australian production of the iconic musical Camelot.
How to handle a woman.
Marina played Queen Guinevere and 60-year-old Richard Harris, her husband, King Arthur, an experience that was life-changing for Marina for a multitude of reasons, mainly due to Richard's tricky and rather difficult carry-on.
Look, I'm not talking out of school, because it is very well known and well documented that Richard Harris, Sir Richard Harris, was one of the... He was known as one of the most difficult people to work with in show business.
And you can confirm this quite merrily.
I can confirm that, yes. People used to say, don't work with children, animals, Yul Brynner or Richard Harris. So he used to do things like, we had an opening night in Perth, and there is a point where my character has to say, Arthur, I wish to go to the joust. And he is to say, well, and so you shall, my queen. And on this particular opening night, I said, Arthur, I wish to go to the joust. And Richard just looked at me and said, no. If I don't get to go to the joust as Queen Guinevere, then I don't meet Lancelot, and there is no story for the rest of the show, so it would be a very short night. But I just sort of looked at him and went, oh, in like this terrible Australian accent.
The experience left Marina wondering if she had what it took to spend a career on stage.
He was tough. He was really, really tough. I actually got to the point of thinking, can I do this? Can I continue on? I think that's where I found out that I was tougher than I looked or than I even believed I was, and I stood up to him. And from the moment that I stood up to him, after sort of months of torment, he treated me like a queen. Nobody has ever intimidated me on stage or off stage since, because I just thought, well, if I can deal with Sir Richard, I reckon I can just about deal with anyone.
In the 90s, Australia was gripped by phantom fever. Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber's hit musical Phantom of the Opera had its Australian debut with Marina as Christine alongside Anthony Warlow and then Rob Guest. The show was a mega hit, becoming one of the longest running productions ever staged in Australia. It was a production that captivated the nation and the world.
Incredible show. You know, we were so lucky to be the right type and the right age when that show, Phantom, first came to Australia, and it was a thrill. Anthony Warlow was extraordinary as the Phantom. He was just hypnotic, and that voice and that charisma, you know, he's extraordinary. But then Rob Guest came along and he was just as extraordinary, and he had a different energy altogether. And it's just one of those, you know, once in a generation type shows that comes along and seems to capture the imagination of the public. And how lucky was I to have been there at the time.
Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest.
Rob Guest holds the record for playing the Phantom more than any other performer. And sadly, 10 years ago, while performing as the Wizard in Wicked, he tragically and suddenly died of a stroke.
I think about him, I miss him. You know, we spent 8 shows a week, day in, day out, for like, well, he did it for years, but we certainly spent a year together. And you become like family. That's part of what I love about theatre. There's not a huge amount of room for enormous egos and tantrums when you're doing 8 shows a week. It's a slog. And so you bond very quickly, and you tend to bond very fast with people. And you know, Robbie had that same thing that John English had, that he would be exactly the same person with the executive producer as he was with the caretaker or the stage doorman. And that's, yes, we won't see someone like him again.
Christmas is one of the busiest times of the year for Marina. She is performing this weekend at a Carols by Candlelight in Perth, and on Christmas Eve at Carols at the Sydney Meyer Music Bowl in Melbourne, an event she's done for almost 30 years.
I love Christmas. I love Christmas music. I sing a lot of Christmas songs only once a year, but, you know, I love carols, and there's something really traditional and magical and sort of dignified about the carols by Candlelight.
Am I right in recalling you've been pregnant once or twice through those?
I feel like I've been pregnant about 12 times on carols.
Did you ever think you might hit a high note and suddenly bang, go into
labour?
Well,
yes. So I have been pregnant 3 times with 3 children on carols.
I'm expecting my own little Christmas present in about half an hour or so. It should be.
My middle son was born 24 hours later. And I remember my obstetrician saying that he was sitting at home watching me, and he had one hand on the remote control for the TV and the other on the remote control for the garage, thinking, do I have to get in the car? Do I have to go? No, she's okay. So that was very uncomfortable, but wonderful.
Little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee, Lord.
Despite being a national treasure and a bona fide Aussie showbiz sensation with that remarkably soaring voice, Marina remains humble and incredibly thankful for what is and continues to be a stellar career.
The way I feel, I think, about being here for so long, it's been 35 years since I started in musicals, and I'm really grateful more than anything. I love what I do. In thee
tonight. Okay, you had a wonderful interview.
Can I say she is so elegant? I mean, yes. Of course, so talented, that goes without saying. An amazing career from busking in the streets when she was 19 to all of those musicals.
What about Dirty Richard Harris?
Oh, what about him? What a sod, eh?
The MacArthur Park singer and all that.
Well, he can put that up his chutney, can't he? Quite frankly, after that. I mean, when Marina said that in Camelot, you know, she's meant to be invited to the ball and he decided one day she's not and this is happening live on stage. What an absolute shocker.
What a cat.
She was on her toes. At least she knows she's got toes.
I met her once at this sort of very intimate sort of pitch for a new musical based on the Nostradamus. And everyone was really starstruck, but the musical wasn't a big hit. You could see the ending coming a mile away.
Good chat. Now, lovely Marina will be touring Australia next year with the one and only David Hobson, doing over 50 shows. How fabulous will that be?
They're great together.
You can get all the details and buy tickets at Marina Prior and DavidHobson.com.